Welcome back to another Casual Friday. Today I'm going to share with you my favorite products from February. And most of you know that I have my weekly makeup basket, so I do go through a lot of products during the month. But today I'm just going to share the ones that really stand out to me this past month. So if you're interested in knowing what those products are, then just keep watching this video. Thanks. So the first thing that I want to mention is a combo that didn't work for me this week, and it's Maybelline The Rocket, which you all of you know that I love this mascara. It gives you volume, it gives you length, and it actually holds my curl all day. Then the Neutrogena Oil-Free Eye Makeup Remover. This, I told you before that this is very similar to the Mary Kay Eye Makeup Remover, but it doesn't really work with my Maybelline The Rocket. I mean, the Eye Makeup Remover will remove this mascara, but it takes you probably 2 to 3 cotton rounds to do it, and you have to constantly dip it into more product in order to remove it. I am very particular about having any mascara in my under eye area. I like to have it completely clean, any eye cream or any cream itself to my face. So I found myself using a lot of product. I found myself not being gentle enough with my eyelids, and I just don't like that. So just beware, if you're gonna buy Maybelline The Rocket, you should probably get something better than the Neutrogena Oil-Free Eye Makeup Remover. The next product is something that I don't love, but I don't hate, but I hauled it pretty recently, and I just wanna mention it because sometimes we watch these videos, haul videos, and we think like we want to get those products, and I'm just gonna give you a heads up. I haven't finished this product, but I use quite a lot because I feel that I have to use eye cream more often than my Mary Kay one. This is the Elizabeth Arden Perpetual Moisture 24 Eye Cream. My under eye area, it's very dry, and this area right here, it's very dry. So I need to use something that really hydrates and moisturizes that area in order to prevent wrinkles and in order to plump the ones that I have already. So this, it hydrates and everything, it feels soft, and I don't know how it will be with wrinkles because I haven't used it that long, but I feel like in the morning, I applied this at 9, and in the morning I feel like this area is dry again. So I don't think it does whatever I want to use it for, because I feel like my Mary Kay Firming Eye Cream is thicker, and for that reason I don't feel like I have to apply it in the morning and at night, even though I try to, but I don't feel like my under eye area is that dry. But every time I use this cream and I wake up in the morning, I have to go to the bathroom and get my skincare done and apply this eye cream because I feel like it's way too dry and that I really can't skip it or wait until the nighttime to use it. The other thing that I think it's worth mentioning is this Physicians Formula Youthful Wear Foundation, and I'm in the color medium. I have a first impression on it, so if you wanna see how it applies and everything, I'm gonna link it down below. But I feel like this foundation, it really helps you with what it claims, which is help you to hide wrinkles or blur them and make your skin look younger. I think this really covers all my imperfections, and it leaves me with a more natural finish, not matte, not satin, but actually looking like my skin without having any imperfections. So it's amazing. This is my favorite drugstore foundation so far. And if you are thinking about trying a new foundation, you like kind of a mousse consistency and that it's not luminous or matte, but at the same time gives you great coverage, I would totally recommend you to get your hands on this foundation. To me, it's really worth it. So then move on to Too Faced products. I tried this set that I got at Ulta. I'm gonna link that video where I got that down below so you can check what it came into it. But three of the products that came in that kit, I'm gonna share them with you because I think they're worth mentioning. I know a lot of people love the Too Faced Chocolate Soleil and that it has a lot of hype here in YouTube, but I want to mention the reasons why I like it. I feel like for my skin tone, I use an NC35 in MAC. I feel like this is the kind of contouring that looks natural. And I know contouring, it's not meant to be natural looking makeup, but I feel like sometimes we get into that shade kind of thing that we want to create in that area. And sometimes it gets way too dark and you can really tell that you're trying, or if you get a bronzer with some sparkle. I mean, it's gonna look like makeup. But this, I feel like whenever I blend it into my skin, it looks very natural. It is very easy to blend. And even though I can create some shadow on that area and make it look more sunken in, I feel like it's not noticeable as other of my bronzers. So I love this Too Faced Chocolate Soleil. Then the other two things that I want to mention from the brand. The first one is the Too Faced Shadow Insurance. This primer, for me, it works amazing. I have oily eyelids and I feel like this really controls the oils in my eyelids and also makes my eyeshadow last longer. I mean, that's the purpose of every single eye primer, but I feel like with other eye primers that I have on my collection, they will make my eyeshadows last, but they don't look as fresh as when I apply this. So if you're looking for an eyeshadow base that actually makes your eyeshadow looks like freshly applied for many, many hours, I would say 10, 12 hours, then I think this is the way to go. For me, it works amazingly. I've heard many people here in YouTube lately saying that they had bad experiences with it, that they had a liquidy kind of a product. I don't find that's true with this. I mean, it's more of a mousse kind of consistency and it works for me. So I don't know if they got a bad batch or what it was. But then the other one is the Too Faced Prime and Poreless. And I am in love with this product. I'm gonna buy the full size as soon as possible because I'm running out of this and I just use it for a week and probably a few days during this month. I feel like this actually fills in your pores, and that way when you apply your foundation, it's not gonna go straight into the pores, but it's gonna go on top of the primer. So my pores look a lot smaller with this just because it really fills in the pores. The other thing that I find with this is when I apply it, no matter with what foundation I use, at least for my skin, it makes them stay longer, but really looking fresh. Once again, it seems like I just applied my makeup and probably I've been wearing my makeup for 8 hours. So I think these two primers really work, and that it actually, I think they're worth the investment. I know they're a high-end product, but I feel like whatever makes my foundation and my eyeshadows last longer and looking better, I think that's the way to go, and I would totally recommend this too. The next thing is this cream eyeshadows. There's no color in particular that I like this month, but I have a video that I uploaded, I think last week, about how to soften your hard or dried Maybelline color tattoos or cream eyeshadows or gel eyeliners. I'm gonna link it down below if you didn't see it, but I've been sneaking in this cream eyeshadows into my weekly makeup basket, and I'm gonna start to mention the colors that I'm gonna be using each week because I feel like since they are in a mousse consistency now, I feel like they are a very good addition to my eye makeup, and I truly love them this month. Then something that it's not gonna really surprise you is the palette that I'm gonna show you, and this is Tarte Magnificent. I love this palette. These are the kind of colors that I look whenever I want to do a matte look. I love these eyeshadows. They're very creamy and you don't feel like you're applying like a powder eyeshadow. They just feel like a cream product. They're very pigmented and they last a really long time on my eyelids, so I really can't complain. And I feel like I'm gonna add it to my weekly makeup basket and just leave it there because it has some great blending colors and also clean up colors, as I call those cream colors that I just clean around the edges of my shadows. So I love this palette, just really, really a staple in my collection. Slowly became a staple in my collection. Then I'm gonna mention my Pixi concealer in Brightening Peach. This thing actually changed my whole concealer corrector kind of routine. I'm always hearing YouTube that you should get a concealer that is 2 shades lighter than your skin tone, but they never tell you to correct your darkness first. And I went to the store, I bought a lot of concealers that they were in light, and I'm not light. And whenever I got home and I tried them on, my under eye area looked ashy and this area looked yellow. So I was wondering what happened, if it was just me or what, and then after doing a lot of research, I realized that I needed to correct the darkness first and then brighten the under eye area. I used for a really long time my Maracuja Chrysalis Concealer as a corrector itself, and then I apply a brightening concealer, but then I bought this Pixi one, and I think this works amazing because it's thicker. So you need the tiniest bit, you just apply it, you push it in, and it doesn't move anywhere. And at the same time, it kind of color corrects that area. And whenever you want to apply a brightening concealer, it's much more of a light effect, and it doesn't really accentuate your darkness in your under eye area. So truly amazing, love it. It has great skin benefits. So I'm gonna be doing a review pretty soon on this product. The last two products are just brushes. The first one is the Real Techniques Deluxe Crease Brush. This, I love to use it for concealer. I feel like I apply my concealer in the back of my hand, I stipple it in, and then I stipple in my under eye area, and that way I feel like my skin really absorbs the product and it doesn't make it move. I don't know, I feel like it gives me a lot of coverage and I'm not swiping the product back and forth. The other thing that I use this brush for is just to apply my MAC Paint Pot or any cream eyeshadows. I feel like it really grabs the exact amount of product that you need without overdoing it, because you know, whenever you overdo your cream eyeshadows before your powder eyeshadows, usually they get harder to blend. So I feel like with this, I don't really have to think about how much blending I have to do before I apply my powder eyeshadows, and I feel like at the same time this works, so I don't have to really touch my eyes with my fingers. And I know it sounds silly, but I feel like my fingers are not the softest tool for my eyes. I feel like I'm always like purring and maybe pulling my eyelids, and I don't want to have any, you know, premature wrinkles. So I feel like whenever I apply it with this kind of brush, I feel like it gives me more control over what I'm doing, and at the same time it prevents me to being rough around my eye area. Then is my Anastasia brush, which has the spoolie on one side, and I love this spoolie because it's dense and so it helps you blend more. And then on the other side is just an angle brush, but I don't know if it's the kind of bristles that they use, how it's cut, how dense it is, I don't know what it is, but today I felt like doing dramatic eyebrows and I did it. Yesterday I wanted natural brows and I did it. It gives you so much control over the product that you're applying that it's really a versatile tool. This works for whatever product I use, my e.l.f. eyebrow kit or my Anastasia deep brow paint. This works the same with both products. I think it's just actually the way that they made this brush that gives you the control to actually know where you're putting the product and how intense you want it to look. So girls, I hope you enjoyed this favorites, and I hope that gives you some insights on this product. So if you were thinking about getting them, that will give you an idea what I think about them. Anyways, this is the third time I tried to do this video. It's dark outside. I don't know if it's gonna rain or snow, but it's actually the weather sucks. So I have a bunch of lamps. I don't think it makes any justice to the products that I show you, but I hope you truly enjoy them anyways, and that you enjoy still having our casual Fridays, because I was actually thinking about not even doing them. I didn't have any kind of lights. So I hope this works anyways. Love you guys. Have a good weekend, and I will see you on Monday. Mwah!